Today, we're going to explore the demographic transition model, a key concept in geography that explains how population growth changes over time as a country develops. This model is divided into five stages, each stage showing birth rate, death rate, and total population level change within economic and social progress. Let's break it down into some easy to follow steps. Step 1. Understanding the DTM. The DTM describes how populations grow and change in different countries as they move from pre-industrial societies to modern developed economies. It is based on historical trends from countries like the UK, but can be applied to other nations. The model consists of five stages, each reflecting different birth and death rates. Stage 1 is high fluctuating. In stage 1, birth rates and death rates are both very high, leading to little or no population growth. This is because of poor healthcare, lack of sanitation, food shortages, and disease, which keeps death rates high, while birth rates stay high to compensate for this. No countries remain at this stage today. However, some remote tribes, such as the Amazonian tribes in Brazil, still experience similar conditions. Stage 2 is early expanding. Death rates rapidly decline due to improved medicine, sanitation, and food supply. But birth rates remain high, leading to rapid population growth. This happens because better healthcare reduces infant mortality, encouraging people to have larger families. Many low-income countries, such as Afghanistan or other parts of sub-Saharan Africa, are at this stage. Stage 3 is late expanding. Birth rates start to decline, and death rates remain low, leading to a slower population growth. This is because improved education, access to contraception, and changing social attitudes mean people may choose to have fewer children. We likely see this in newly emerging economies such as India, Mexico, and Brazil. Stage 4 is low fluctuating. Both birth and death rates are low, and population growth is stable. This is because countries are wealthier, healthcare is advanced, and women have more career opportunities, leading to smaller families. Many high-income countries, like the USA, the UK, and France, are in this stage. Stage 5, declining population. Birth rates for the first time fall below death rates, leading to a shrinking of population over time. This is because high living costs, aging population, and changing attributes towards family size result in fewer births. Countries like Japan and Germany are already starting to experience population decline. Evaluating the DTM. Strengths of the model include the DTM being able to explain why populations change over time, is based on real-world data, making it a useful tool to predict population trends. It applies to many countries that have followed this pattern. However, there are limitations to the model. It is Eurocentric, so not all countries follow the exact same pattern as seen in Europe. It does not account for migration, which can be significant in population change, and the model assumes that all countries will develop, but some may face barriers to economic progress. Now you understand the DTM and how it explains population changes over time, while it provides a great framework, it is important to remember that not all countries follow the model perfectly.